How's it going, everybody? Welcome back to another amazing video by yours truly. I'm the number one MLG Call of Duty Alpha, 6'6", 255 pounds of raw Call of Duty athletic sexuality, all right? Oh, Lord, guys, can we all just smash that like button for a prayer? One like equals one prayer for the Infinity Ward developers because, oh, my God, guys, they're getting bullied. They're getting bullied. People are sending them death threats. People are talking trash to them. They block anybody and mute anybody on Twitter who's mean to them or is just not behaving like an adult. And, like, listen, first of all, if you're sending death threats and whatnot to developers and getting that angry and that worked up over a video game, that might be a bit of an over, you know, it might be a little bit overzealous. You might be a little overreacting. I gotta keep it real there. But, like, anybody who has a presence online, present company included, in any way whatsoever on social media, and even if you don't even have a present, are told all the time to go kill themselves. I don't know how many times people have said, oh, your Asian wife ate thoughts, and you hope you die, I hope your cancer kills you, you're a piece of shit, I hope your parents die, you're a big bald-headed loser, hope the cancer, hope you die of a heart attack, etc., etc. Like, dude, come on, man, that's the internet, that's how it goes online. And if you're the developer for the biggest game rolling, biggest selling game, most played game, you've got to expect that pissed off fans are going to come at you pretty hard. And like I said, I'm not advocating it's cool out here to be sending death threats to, you know, developers and behaving that way. It's not cool. I'm like, you know what? I'm a troll myself. I try to be a little bit more eloquent about my roast. I'm not just going to come straight out and be like, go kill yourself. Like I'm some like 14-year-old edgelord. Like I got myself a Rick and Morty t-shirt on. Oh my God. Oh. Like, no, I'm not rolling like that. But like, I'm a little more articulate. I try to be a little bit more, you know, funny about it. And at the same time, it's just a video game. Yes, I know we paid for this game, and these douchebag developers definitely deserve to be clowned. They definitely deserve to be trolled. They deserve the hate, like, without a doubt. They don't want to listen to what's going on. But the whole thing about, like, them trying to distract us from the fact that the game sucks, and they're not listening to us, and it seems that they're not going to listen to us, and there's some more news actually came out pertaining to them not listening to us about this overhaul that isn't actually ever going to happen. You know, spoiler alert, hate to be the bearer of bad news, but they're trying to distract from the fact that they're not going to listen to us and they are going to make the game what it is. And if there aren't a bunch of people fired like it happened at Sledgehammer Games with Michael Condry and Glenn Schofield, I don't foresee this game really becoming what a lot of us, at least on this channel and a lot of people online, hoped it would be or hope it could be. I mean, it's not ever going to reach its full potential. I mean, what I'm talking about when it's not ever going to reach its full potential is this Twitter interaction with Joel Seesaw, the head of multiplayer at Infinity Ward. Remember when we were told we would have a huge overhaul by the end of November? It is now December and we still have yet to see this overhaul. Nice way to say fuck you at Joe Seesaw. Overhaul was a fake statement to get attention. We are constantly updating the game at least once a week, sometimes twice. Season 1 incoming. Also, bye. Get roasted, bro. Yeah, peace out. You just got blocked, probably, or muted. First of all, I don't know if the overhaul was a fake statement. I mean, the gaming revolution was talking about how it was supposed to be, you know, some big, huge overhaul. But yet, no, that Ashton chick or whatever, the community director or, you know, head of the community, she was the one hyping it up, talking about huge changes were coming, big changes were coming. It's going to have like 15 pages of patch notes and whatnot. So, like, I don't know if that really was a fake statement to get attention by someone. Joe, I would like to say that your own head of the community, aka I'll block anybody who's not nice to me, gotta have safe spaces on the internet and in my video games, was the one hyping it up there, bro. So anyways, so like I said, unless these clowns get fired, I can't foresee this game really ever becoming what we would hope it would be or really reach its full potential. But to get more into the whole bullying aspect of the game and these Infinity Ward developers crying like that doesn't happen to everybody on the internet, it's to distract us from the fact this game sucks and to try to distract us from the fact that they don't want to listen and they aren't going to make changes. So it sort of seems like just some kind of like sympathy ploy, like, oh my God, they're so mean to us. Oh my God, this is so awful. I just feel so bad right now. My feelings are hurt and I feel like this is really sad. I don't like it. Alright, so Infinity Ward Dev says people have sent death threats on Reddit. Oh my God. Oh no. Where's my safe space? Is there a safe space down here? Look, you guys got a safe space there? Where's your safe space?
Is there a safe space around here? Hey, hey, do you see a safe space over here? I need a safe space. I'm scared right now. I need to find a safe space.
One leg equals one safe space.
Infinity Ward developer has stated on Reddit that he has been receiving private messages on Reddit that are death threats about how people want to hurt his children. Like I said, bit crazy, wouldn't really go there. That's a little bit of an over-exaggeration, a little overreaction about a video game. I understand there's some butthurt people out there, and you know, like, but like, present company included, I troll, I like to roast these guys, but that's a bit far, but it's the internet. It's expected to happen. I get it all the time. Joe Seesaw posted on Reddit when a fan said, "Thank you for continuing to work on the game," saying the studio is hard at work on bringing updates to the game. He said that he'd prefer less PMs about his children dying horrible deaths. It can be rough. I'd prefer less PMs about my children dying horrible deaths and spend less time here. Thanks for the thanks. We're still working crazy hard. He also notes that he has been spending a lot less time on Reddit because of the threats and harassments, which makes sense. Definitely want to go there. That's not a safe space at all. No need to be harassed constantly versus getting real criticism. Seesaw is not the first Infinity Ward dev to be harassed. The studio's senior CM has tweeted out, community manager has tweeted out that she is not going to take harassment and will just ignore those who do.
Hi, I'm Ashton Zoo, I'm Ashton Williams. We get tons of tweets and emails and comments all over the internet. We cannot respond to every single person. I refuse to respond to comments that call me names, bitch, are racist, you f***ing n***a, and just all around shitty. No one deserves that, and we're all adults.
Well, I'm more than an adult. I'm an alpha male elite gaming all-star stud muffin, unlike that dork blame truth that drives a station wagon. This is not the first time in Call of Duty that developers have received death threats, and it won't be the last. Vaughn, charged studio director, has written abundant of death threats over the years from some insane people in this community. Yeah, you guys are crazy, bro. You need to calm down. Especially in Black Ops 2 when he changed snipers in that game at the time. Sending constructive criticism is totally fine. It actually helps the developers make positive... Sending constructive criticism is totally fine and actually helps the developers make positive changes to the game. If they listen. If they listen. They don't listen. So, you know what? Maybe the death threats might work. I don't know. Just joking. Don't send them any. It's all just a little bit overreaction about a video game. But no, sending constructive criticism doesn't actually help the developers because they ain't listening, bro. Sending death threats is insane and immature. Yes, very much so. Thank you, Keshav. Beat. So, ladies and gentlemen, in closing, these guys made a crappy game. They're not going to listen. I guess the big overhaul was as a lie, even though it was pumped up by Ashton, the community manager from Infinity Ward. I got it right this time. And they're trying to make us feel sorry for them by saying they're getting death threats, and they're going to block you, and they're going to mute you. And Charlie Intel says that we should keep giving them constructive criticism because it helps the developers make changes to the game. Which is not going to because they aren't listening to us. So people get pissed off and send them death threats. And everybody on the internet who has any presence on the internet has been told way worse every day almost. That's just how it goes on the internet when you have autonomy and people don't have any, you know, repercussions or any consequences for what they say. And that's just how it goes. It's not a big deal. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching the video. I, not Blame Truth, a little pencil neck geek, and the most alpha male Call of Duty Elite Gaming alpha stud muffin athlete, not driving some station wagon mom soccer car, driving trucks and an Infiniti Q50. That's how I roll. Thanks for watching. Be cool, stay in school, stay on the drugs, and look both ways for crossing the street, help prevent forest fires. Make sure to brush and floss regularly, help promote healthy oral hygiene. Smash that like button, subscribe, and I'll see you all next time. Peace out. Thanks very much. Merry Christmas.